is and who is to come.
Jesus.
We bless your name for today.
Amen.
We bless your name for the gathered souls under Amen. The umbrella of your grace.
Amen.
I pray that, Lord, you visit us in a special way.
Amen.
Let lives be touched. Let destinies be transformed.
Amen.
Let souls be impacted for your work of Amen. The Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, I take authority over every work, every spirit of the devil, every arrangement and every organization that is not of you. I stop it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Help us to draw closer to you,
Jesus,
even as we share your word in Jesus' mighty name. Let the whole house respond with a better amen.
Amen. One more one, seven on page.
Keep standing as we take our first reading from Ephesians chapter 4.
Verse 8,
then I'll pick it up from verse 11 downwards. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 8, then we continue from verse 11 onwards. I read let us read together. Wherefore he said, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Verse 11. He gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers. Continue. For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Verse 13. Till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man. Unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Last verse 14. That we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive. Amen.
Amen. Kindly
take your miracle seats. Clap for Jesus.
Amen. Na wama ebinum aye asumafo, ebinum edifo, ebinum asempakafo, ebinum ahwefo, ne achechirefo, na watoto amotifo niye ama osume dumano, ama Kristo ni pebianu siye akoso. Akodri se ye nyina bedru nyankopon ba no hudidie, ne ne hunu mu ba kuye mu, aye onipa a wewie nyini, aye dru Kristo, maye susudia no tinabia so. Amen. Na yanda so anya mwatafuwa a intechira mfla mebi ya rawosu won. Biri biri etu wendi ya kwane ya ba inipa brade tuwe mu. Inifle a enam inada inade mu. Amen.
So the focus of my teaching series which I'm beginning today.
Enano pe ye intechira yesha si efri enekuroi.
Will be on verse 14.
Ninyina ejina eti dunayeno so. Nimu dunayeno.
So take me back to Ephesians 8:14.
Enti yako Ephesians 4 woman eti na ninyimu dun.
That we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive. My series is titled Developing Your Staying Power as a Christian. Amen.
Amen.
Developing your staying power as a Christian. Love for Jesus.
Yen chechira yesha sie ewo bosomia edi enimu ni na gya se wo ma wo ho ayeden ewo Kristo sumu.
Developing the ability to stay in your Christian faith. Developing your staying power, having your roots grounded in the Christian faith. The scripture is telling us that days are coming and we are in those days where people will be running to and fro.
People
will be running from one church to the other, visiting one prayer meeting to the other prayer camp. In search of miracles, in search of business, in search for destinies that are uncovered or that are raveled in a mystery.
So
your ability to stand, your ability to endure, your ability to stay for the second coming of Christ is what is going to determine whether you'll be raptured or you'll be left behind. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
If you put a seed into the ground or into the soil, you cultivate a land, and after a couple of weeks or months, whatever seed you put into the ground, you lift it up and plant it elsewhere. What is going to happen to the seed? The chance, the probability of the seed dying is high, or the inability of the seed to be able to grow, mature, and bear fruit is also there. God is expecting every believer to be a fruit-bearing Christian.
There
are a lot of believers in churches who are fruitless and barren. They don't do anything to enhance their church or the work of ministry. And the resultant effect of that is because we are not grounded, we are not rooted. So we move from one church after 3 months, he changes church after 1 year, he changes church after 2 years. So it's like by the time you are dead, your name has been registered in about 17 churches in Ghana.
And
if you cultivate that habit, that lifestyle, you will never mature and bear fruit. Tell your neighbor, you need to stay your ground. You need to be established. You need to have your roots deep in Christ. Jesus. Now, what is staying power? I define staying power as the ability to contain yourself at a place despite problems. The ability to contain yourself. The ability to keep yourself grounded. At a particular place, despite the problems
you see.
Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
The ability to keep yourself at a place. Is the staying power.
Number
two, the strength you need to prevail over or survive a destructive storm. Somebody say, the strength I need
to prevail over
the strength I need
to overcome
to survive
the test of time
against destructive storms. Life comes with uninvited storms. There are things you don't project and predict. But before you are aware, it is at your doorsteps. We have a lot of prophets in Ghana. A lot of prophets in Africa. None of them could predict COVID-19. Before we were aware, COVID had already landed and had begun a fair distribution of the virus from one community to the other. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
So you see, life comes with storms. If a tree is there and the roots are not deep in the soil, it may look nice and beautiful for a while. Allow the winds to blow. Allow the waves and the hurricanes and the tornadoes. Allow them, the typhoons, when they start blowing against the tree, it will just fall without being able to perform its original intent. That is a description of your life and my life. The Bible likens our Christian life to a tree planted in the soil, the rivers of waters. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Are we together, church?
Yawaha.
We need spirit power in like this. Need a staying in trying moments. Say, God help me. I can't feel that we are in church at all.
You're
too gentle, you're too nice for me.
And you can't
respond with your voice. Say, God,
help me.
Help me to stay my ground.
To stay my ground. Amen.
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 Then thirdly, staying power talks about the capacity to master control over the forces militating against your life, purpose, and calling. Every one of you have been called to do something. There is a purpose to your life. There's a call of God on your life. From the day you were born to the day you die, God has a special assignment on your life. Somebody, I'm talking to you. God has a work for you to accomplish with your life here on earth. And your ability to fully accomplish that purpose will be connected to the power, the capacity to master control. The capacity to master control over certain forces, over certain powers. Ephesians chapter 6, the scripture accounts, for we are not wrestling against flesh and blood. Hey, we are in a wrestling match. Maybe you are not aware. Look at the dreams you used to have. Look at the things that come your way. It's about wrestling your way through life. And what we are fighting with, we can't see with our optical eyes. There are forces. There are powers. There are demons. There are demonic creatures that are sanctioned and permitted to fight against certain souls on earth. If you don't stay your ground, if you don't master control, something would throw you overboard. You are in Christ today. After 6 months, you will be found in a club, clubbing with people and insulting pastors and insulting preachers and talking about churches and things like that. Most of the MPs. They used to be Christians. They started well. Along the line, something visited them. They were unable to stay their ground. They gave up and consulted mediums. Consulted other powers. And I'm speaking to somebody. Your soul is valuable. I'm saying your soul is precious. The equivalent monetary currency for your soul is the blood of Jesus. So maybe you don't know and you are joking with your soul and where your soul is going to get to in the final analysis. Your soul is precious. And it is what the devils and the demons of our time are after. But I rebel against any devil. I rebel against any spirit who would want to take me to hell. Tell your neighbor, pastor seems to be talking to you. Have you rebelled against certain factors that are militating against your Christian faith? You need to rise up in the spirit. You need to be tough in the spirit. You need to build your armors well to stand and to contend and to resist the powers that will be fighting against the destiny of your soul. By the end of this series, I pray God will empower the church. I pray God will empower you with the power of stability. As with the power of stability. With the grace to stand. The Bible says, having done all, stand. Having done all, stand. Having done all, stand. Now, our character study for this series, one of the Bible characters we are going to pick, our character study, one of the Bible characters for this series, it's going to be the life of Job. The life of Right Reverend Bishop Canon Apostle Job in the Bible. Hallelujah, somebody.
Praise the Lord.
If you scan through the life of Job, you
will
find three stages of his life. The first stage of the life of Job talks about the treasures of life. The treasures of
Job.
Then he entered another phase of his life, which is called the trials and the tragedies of Job. So you see the treasures of Job. Then you see the trials and the tragedies he went through. And the last phase of his life talks about the triumphs of Job. The triumphs of
Job.
So in life you will have treasures, but the treasures will come with trials and tragedies. And you need staying power to triumph over them. And may God help somebody today. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
Now, this is the introduction to the series.
So
I'm not going to take much of your time. Let me run you through areas you need staying power as the bedrock for our series. That is going to be the bedrock. Areas you need to develop your staying power. The first area you need to develop your staying power is the area of, are you giving it to me? Your Christian life. Amen.
Amen.
Are we together?
Yeah, we're high.
You need staying power in your Christian life.
Your Christian life
must be in proper sequence.
Say
And it takes staying power to set right priorities for your Christian walk. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
You have a lot of prophets in town.
Whether
they are operating by mediums, operating by demonic invited viruses. Some of you can't foresee and you can't tell. Because you are like, if you are capable of helping me solve that problem, I'm okay. But you are not really considering where your soul will go afterwards. If you find a particular place to establish your faith in God, you must begin the process of development.
In
that particular church.
That
is why we have Bible study groups.
Women's
ministry, men's ministry, young ladies, all these auxiliary ministries. They are there to establish souls in Christ.
As
believers, they shine the meetings of such fellowships.
He
would rather go to Osofo for prophecy than to visit Meku when they have meetings. Somebody in church, you need staying power in your Christian
walk.
Then you need staying power in the work of ministry. I will handle each of them, so I'm just walking you through where you need staying power. You need staying power. Say in the work of ministry. I can't hear people in church. We are not together at all. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
You see, as a leader and as a pastor over this church, if I don't develop staying power in the work into which I have been called, I will follow the dreams and the caprices and the fantasies of day and try to bring in something that will easily multiply the attendance. If God had been using me to heal headaches, I will try to manage my way through and get more powers that when I throw my hands, all this side of the church will be down.
Then
you see the applauded responses. Wow, what an anointed man. What a powerful
man.
The next time I come to church,
I said,
God visit me in my dreams. And I have come with a special direction.
Hey.
When God visited me, this direction had been given only to me.
Sometimes
preachers, we talk like the Holy Spirit is a personal property.
So
he speaks to me and to me alone. And this direction has been given to me alone.
A
blatant liar. The Holy Spirit is speaking, distributing the graces and the anointing and the visions of God. Say amen, somebody. Inasmuch as I need staying power in the work of ministry, you also need a staying power so that whatever you have been called to do in church, you stay your ground and do it. Are we together?
Yawaha.
Clap for Jesus. Number three, you need staying power in your marriage.
And
praise God. All the unmarried ones, right, shepherd? You need staying power the day you marry. Evangelist, you are here. Look at how they are nicely dressed. God punished the devil for you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So that you don't end up sitting in front and your wife behind. When they come to church, they will behave like they are enemies, hostile environment. Most marriages began very nice.
But
with the passage of time, then they began to open up gaps.
Here
a little, there a little. Then they open gaps. I tell you, even in Trotro, if we should pass a law that anytime you enter trotro with your wife or husband, sit on the same seat. Some men will never board that vehicle their wives bought. I tell you, you allow the wife to go ahead. Doesn't want the wife to be close at all. And he was the same guy who said, for better, for worse, I do. God help us all. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
So we need staying power in our marriages. Number 4. You need staying power in relationships. Relationships. A friend in need is a friend indeed. A friend who helps you when you are in need is a friend indeed. And we need to build proper relationships in church. Oh, your response. Do you know a story about David and Jonathan?
David and Jonathan.
They should have been hostile friends. Because after the death of Saul, the person who should have risen to the throne, all things being equal, should have been Jonathan.
But
Jonathan comes to David and says, I see in the spirit, I can download that God has given the throne to you.
David,
I'm not here to fight you.
David,
but I'm here to make a request. That when God gives you the throne, remember my descendants. A friend in need is a friend indeed. We need proper relationships in church, in marriages, in businesses, in social world. Amen. So we will be talking about staying power in your relationships. Number 5. You need staying power. Number 5. In the doctrines of Christ. I want to quickly read Galatians 1:8-9. As we draw closer to the message. But though we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto him, let him be accursed.
Amen.
Verse 9. We said before, so say I now again, if a man preach any other gospel unto you than that you have received, let him be accursed.
Amen. Galatians 4 woman etiba ko ni mu enkono ni mu wotwene eduno ose na se impo ye ana abofuo bi firisuru ba beka asempa fufuro bi kiremo kan de ye ka kiremo no ho a onue ni mu nkono se de ye ka no kane no Sarana after me can be said, Obi Babeka as I'm Papu Frobi Chiramo, Candia, one general are only Amen.
So Paul is signing a warning to the Galatian church.
And to Paul, Ebba Galati as a Funopoko.
Hey, watch out, oh! So many radio stations in town.
Radio station in Brevo Chrome.
Whoever comes to preach another gospel.
The Obi Babeka as I'm Papu Fro.
Which is far removed from what we have preached.
Ah, and can the yeah can one?
What is the gospel Paul was talking about?
I've
talked to you about what is the gospel?
Yeah,
what is the gospel Paul preached? God's only Son provides eternal life. That is the gospel that should be preached. The gospel, gene for God. God's O for only, S for Son. God's only Son. P for provides. E for eternal. L for life. So God's only Son provides eternal life. This is the gospel. If anybody comes to preach the gospel according to Pastor John.
The Bible
says, let him be accursed. The gospel according to Prophet Wabuka. The gospel according to evangelist so and so. If
it doesn't
fall within what I have shown you, the Bible says, let the preacher himself be accursed. And then listen to the verse 9. If you be the recipient of the message, if you shift your ears from receiving the unadulterated gospel of Christ to listen to fables, then the scripture in verse 9 is saying that you are also cursed. There's a curse on the preacher, there's a curse on the listener. So when I preach a foreign gospel and curse, I'll go to hell. You being the listener, the recipient of the message, I'm distributing curses, and so are you going to be part of my condemnation? You don't know scriptures and you don't know what is going to happen in the last days. So some preachers, where they have gotten to, they can never repent. They already have the mark of the Antichrist. They have that anti-spirit within. They can never change. So what they do is to preach a foreign gospel so that the curse upon their lives will be transmitted to the hearers. I'm not into a Jimmy. Praise God.
Amen.
That is why you should be careful about the doctrines, the teachings, the preaching, the sermons we hear on radio. I've already told you one day before Jesus comes, it's either you will see Kingdom TV,
Kingdom Television,
or you will see something by TV. Although we are not in TV world now, we are already in Facebook and we are already in YouTube.
Facebook and YouTube.
Yes, that is why we pick the sermon in English. Not until we get there,
you
need to pray for whoever you listen to on radio, in TV
TV so and now we be a radio
so that you don't become a partaker of curses.
Amen.
You can give a better
clap.
Number 6 and 7. You need staying power in your calling. Most evangelists have become songwriters. Most Bible teachers have forced themselves into the office of prophets. Prophesying things they have not seen. Somebody said, it is good to remain the leg of an elephant than to become the head of an ant. Did you hear? It's good to remain the leg of an elephant.
Because
the leg of an elephant, if you put 1 million ants together, it cannot still measure.
Stay
in your calling, remain a leg. Than becoming the head of an ant. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I speak to those who play instruments, those who sing in churches. The new password is called Shabu. Shabu. I have a schedule on Sunday. 7 to 9, visit the Catholic Church. 9:30 to 11:30, I must be in Presbyterian. 11:45, getting to 1, I must be in Prophet Abuke's end because he doesn't close on time.
So,
as soon as he finishes singing, the message is for them, not for him. The message is for them. He has finished his ministry. Goes to the other one. Over there, he will not listen to preaching. Oh yeah, I'm done with ministry. Prophet Abuka.
So
look at the kind of songs we now have in Africa. Compared to the songs sang by Tejo's sisters, daughters of glorious sisters, Edamreku and the ancient singers. But today is everything for double double. We for double double. Yes. Cocaine for double double. Everything na be double double.
Bibia yemprenu. Bibia yenyamomo.
So bocho. What is this?
We ayanyom.
Boys abre. Girls kasa. Fahoma Yesu. Yesterday I said the tenep titinwa who konyamia sorry if you know drew entrance, but be a puppet in one. You fully respect the presence of God. But then
they
go to churches.
So
for if you don't have self-control.
So for the winya was a swa.
You'll be carrying the virus of lust before you visit
home.
But we pray for a staying power
to
remain in our calling. And the last place for staying power. You need staying power in a particular church. I said in a particular church. In a particular church. Read the last scripture in Deuteronomy 12, 13 and 14. Particular church, you need a staying power.
Yeah.
Take heed to thyself that thou offer not thy burnt offerings in every place that thou seest. Continue. But in the place which the Lord shall choose in one of thy tribes, there thou shalt offer thy burnt offerings, and there thou shalt do all that I command. Amen.
Amen.
Clap for the reading of the scripture.
Mose woman eto sunum. Eti du mienu nini mu du mien sani du nan. Ose hwe wo hu ye na wo amma wo sie afo de bebia ro a wo hunu. Je fa kwa Ewurade be yi ho wo musua kwo ba kwu mu no. E wona bo wo sie afo de na ye de mense wo nyina. Amen.
So one of what? The tribes, one of the churches, whether Presby, Anglican, Methodist. In Bible days, it was called tribes, but in our time, they are churches. If you find where God wants you to burn your sacrifices and your offerings, stay there for 20 years. Stay there for 30 years. You are in church. Your children are with you. Whoever joins your roof in your home must be there. Except on certain unusual conditions and restrictions. I have always said that the Catholic Church is one of the best churches. I have said this. You know why? Because they have the staying power. Everybody under the sound of my voice here. It's either you are from a Catholic or from somewhere you switch. If the Catholic Church should have been a one-man church and so-called charismatic, as we say, Reverend, the church would have collapsed. But you see the church always standing. 7 to 8:45 is for service, and you visit there and the house is full. So-called Pentecostal, so-called charismatics. We have become charismatic stubborns and rascals and rebels. Church begins at 7. Prophet, you hear so called 100 Ghana. Prophet, you been
seen it.
So we downplay the importance of holy things. As I close, I want you to watch this video. You have it in about 3 minutes. Be quiet. Just observe. Be quiet. This is an ancient preacher of the gospel. Watch out. Preaching the gospel for the salvation of souls.
Okay.
Elia one side, she another one. The campu a jidi phone ina kugu prison. The domo comment ya turning seba mamari wo in a big stadium. Any party so money aje. Watch out. The develop will stay in power with Christosumu. Shawo mo beni na yebo.
We will be true to thee.
Come with the woman, yes, if you do. About time we must on ban a ban of one in the people. Would it be a big fat? Raindrops, no church. Doomsday, no church. Raindrops, no church. Headache, no church. I'm poor. I'm sick. There's the so many excuses.
Yes,
Bad your heads. Compare what you just observed.
Even
if you didn't hear my sermon, have memories of the pictures and ask yourself, do you have a staying power? Jesus is at the door. Where are you? He asked the question to Adam. Where are you was the question he asked to Adam. And today I ask the same question. I re-echo the voice of my master. In your Christian walk. In your marriage. In the doctrines of Christ. In your calling. In the work of ministry. Where are you? In your church. Are you known as a church member and a regular church member? Pray to God. Ask him for forgiveness. Ask him to strengthen you. Pray for staying power. Tell God to empower you. Never to give up. Storms will show up. Trials and tragedies. Evil occurrences and orchestrations. As for the grace.
In the quietness of your heart, you are here and have a deep feeling within that you have backslidden, you are far from God.
You are the best person to witness to yourself. I may see you to be good. But in the eyes of God, you are not. So you can be the best witness to yourself. You want to come back home. You want to come back home. You want to come back home. You want to come back to God. You want to renew your commitment. I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you. You can lift up your hand if you are here. And the message is for you that you need to make amends. You need to have a turn around. You need to make resolutions in your heart. I want you to lift up your hand and I'll pray with you. Right, I see a hand up. I pray. Let the person respond. Say, Dear Lord Jesus. Speaking three for the person to hear. Dear Lord Jesus.
Mira Yesu.
I have come back again.
My son Abba won champion.
Have mercy on my soul.
We may cry my boy and pay.
Based on what I have heard from your servant this morning, I choose to repent. I choose to renew my commitment. Please help me by your precious Holy Spirit to be able to live for you, serve you, do all your obedience until the day of Christ's return. Thank you for receiving me. In Jesus' name. Father, I pray for the entire church.
Amen.
Help us to be doers of your word.
Amen.
And not only hearers, deceiving ourselves. Amen. I pray for somebody who is at the verge of giving up.
Jesus.
Pray that the Holy Spirit will release a new passion and a new strength and a new joy and a new grace.
Amen.
That will be able to stay our grounds and, amen, follow the call of God on our lives.
Amen.
Thank you even for the marriage ceremony that happened yesterday. And thank you for the lives of all who joined in celebration and have come to appreciate your good works.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for hearing us this day, this morning, this hour. In Jesus' mighty name, let the whole church give a proper response to that.
Amen. Amen.
When you get to heaven, you see your friends and the folks from church. The first will be last, and then the last will be the first. And I hope you